Alright guys, what's going on? So we are back with the final Fears to Fathom game. I know this came out like 2 months ago, but I've been just busy with school and everything. So we finally have time to play it, and I'm looking forward to it. And I think without a further ado, let's hop right in. I don't know anything about the game, but the Ironback Lookout one, which was the last one, was pretty scary, and then a few of the others were pretty creepy too. So hopefully this one holds up to what we're getting at here. December 8th. Needed coffee to get done with the day. Needed to prepare a cup. Oh. Let's do this one. And then we'll do this. It needed water. Wait, the cup did? Or the thing? To put on a lid there. Needed to use restroom. Oh wait, or a girl? I don't want to get up. There's someone else in the bathroom. Fuck! I saw it coming too. I saw it. I heard it, him coming too, and I still got scared somehow. My phone is ringing. Hello?
Hey, Harp, it's Mike.
Hello, Mike.
I've been trying to call your cell for the last 2 hours. It just keeps going to voicemail. Is everything all right? Oh, snap. I was starting to think maybe you were ignoring me. I'm just kidding. What are you still doing at work? It's getting kind of late. Damn, Harp, that sounds rough. Good thing I called to cheer you up. About our trip, did you get a chance to book the rental house? Just really wanted to see you. And Nora. No worries, Harper, I don't want to stress you out. As long as you book it tonight, I think it'll be fine. Hey, I was thinking, since we both live in the city, maybe I could pick you up and ride together. It'd be nice to catch up.
Sure.
You know, save on gas and relive the good old days. Just a little bit of Mike and Sydney time before Nora gets there. Great. I guess I'll let you get back to work then. Wait, one more thing. When you book the rental, please make sure to keep it under $100 a night. Nora and I were talking, and she's been on a pretty tight budget. Things haven't been going very well for her. It'll be just like the old college days. You always had a knack for finding the best spots. Remember that little cafe you found on our trip to Oregon? Yeah. I miss those days, Harp. Right, of course. Sorry for yapping. I'm just excited, I guess. Alright, talk to you later, Harp.
Bye. We're going into spreadsheets at work. What? Oh, wait, take that. Kinda sick, actually. Now I have like six, I assume, in front of me. I know this is a part of the game, but this is like really fun actually. Go back to our spreadsheets. 50k. Oh, I have to make the booking. Oh, rent cab, okay. Woodbury. And 350. Looks good. Hey, I'm assuming you get hundreds, if not thousands, of stories sent daily. So I'll give you a basic rundown of something that happened to me. I'm sorry if some of it is written weird, but I was rushed. When I was in my early 20s, I worked at a big consulting firm in my city. Life at the firm was a constant juggle of deadlines, client meetings, and trying to prove my worth, which didn't leave much room for leisure, let alone a social life. The job paid well, sure, but at the expense of my mental peace. I'm Sydney Harper, and this story takes place during one of those days. One of my college friends, Mike, suggested that we take a weekend getaway to the rural Vermont, which sounded like a perfect break from my cycle of work. Me and my other friend, Nora, was quick to jump on board as well. Oh, and my other friend, Lauren. The plan was simple. We rent a small cabin, close our shift on early on Friday, leave, and be back out on Monday. Mike came to pick me up. 2 days later. Actually went to school in Vermont. Then I transferred this past, stuff in the back and we'll be on our way. Wait, didn't I forget my suitcase? And a throw bag in the back first. Why does he fall in 368? Oh, the bag's in the... doing a few more of these games coming up. There's a few on Steam that I've noticed that look cool. Alright then, Harper, you ready to hit the road? Let's do this. Wait. Wait. Where's the friend? 4:26 p.m. Starting to stop. Isn't it weird in this game to dream? Wait, we used to dream about Scooby. Trying to escape from life. Change is just hard. Like trying to adjust to their job. Working on this project that uses machine learning to predict market trends. Tony Stark yet, but I'll take it. I understood what a consultant you would do. That sounds like important work. Have you ever missed college? Creepy. check. I was thinking that was someone's idea of turning into a tiny home or something. The guy in the front looks like a ripped ocean. Should be about an hour and a half in here. You know, driving through the snow kind of feels like we're traveling through. Look at the waves of like swirl around. It's like stars and galaxies rushing past us. It's kind of beautiful. By 14 p.m. Stop at the diner.
Just in, reports of a strong snowstorm coming towards Woodbury. Residents are
recommending folks to stay indoors. Cold's got everyone scared.
Let's check the
road. You find folks on the way. Wait, did I just pick?
I'm just clearly the better
one.
You can worry about where you'll report once
one
you get back to Rhino.
Rhino? Why would I need Rhino plastic? My face looks perfectly fine.
You could also use some Botox while you're at it. Actually, maybe you should just work as a studio light engineer for Rhino Gamble. I think you'll be better filled at work with
you. Well, you've got your job because your sister works at the mixing pool. You would have never been able to work here if it wasn't for her. I'd like to see you work.
You guys are going to hate me. I swear, I'll get on the road as soon as I can. But something last minute popped up. I'm not going to bore you with all of the details. The long and short of it is, one of my clients needs a last minute change. Their payments are about the only thing keeping the lights on. I hate to leave so late, but I've got to keep them happy. I'll have this logo done before you know it and be on my way.
Yes, sir. Yeah, I just saw it. Looks like she'll be late. That's a bummer. I guess we'll have to start the fun without her. Don't know. Yeah. perfect fuel for the last leg of our trip. Going on. 5:49 p.m.
Good evening, Vermont. This is your host on WKWB, your hometown station, bringing you the best tunes to warm your hearts on this chilly night. As we embrace the first snowfall of the season, there's nothing like a perfect song to set the mood. So here's a track that'll make you feel right at home. Coming up next, Be Sincere. Stay tuned.
I don't want to talk about what crashed Mike's truck.
Can take her up and out of my life. I think the words come together well, and that's no coincidence. Trying to be the best that I could be without no wishing it. Feeling like a plane trying to soar in the sky, but without you feel so hesitant. I can't lie, I'm trying to be a millionaire before I'm 25. Maybe I'm like halfway, maybe I can make it there. I ain't trying to slow down, cause I'm trying to retire my mama and my old man. I don't worry about all the drama, yeah, I keep it cool, I keep a mystery. Hearing lies, man, that ain't all there is to me. I'm trying to fill your heart, but writing on a shitty screen. And I promise you we'll be about the strife, but my life in the heart, so I focus when I type. Trying to get a good song, but can't get it if I try. So I sit up in my room, right, reflecting on my life. I don't know where I'm going, but I hope I get it right.
Where's the house? Why are we doing?
I can't go to you, and I want
can dip. Fuck therapy, I need a fucking reason to live. I sit at night watching movies till I fall asleep. Counting sheep doesn't work for me, so I rhyme on beats. Check my phone, get it buzzing, I slip in the spot. What's the point of trying to hit you if you ain't around? I'm looking for a little time to waste. I really need to contemplate when move forward. So I lose hoping, sit in mirror and try to piece myself together. I'm losing up in my heart, I'm losing whatever weather. I'm trying to get my feet on the ground so I move, and I'm trying to step about my head and maybe.
Check in. last few folks left a bad word for it. You know, they say to treat your guests like family. My family doesn't go that far. Speaking of that, you man over here. Go for it, dude. Host was the middle-aged man with a nervous energy. Right from the start, his presence made us uncomfortable. Here's your shower and take that thing to make you feel like you're breathing under a waterfall in the Amazon. Oh, this sink doesn't work, unfortunately. Not to worry, I'll get it fixed for you real soon. Let me show you the other bedroom. Out, you can use this flashlight here in my room. Seems like these, you never know. Thanks. Alright, folks, let's head downstairs now. Sir, what's the deal with the room over here? Nothing you two need to concern yourself with. Kinda use the basement as a storage. Renters don't need the space. They really ought to keep upstairs. Okay, well, I was just curious. Let's move on. Jesus, bro. Did I mention? Well, no. Maybe the fella I bought this house from. Said they could hear something shuffling around down here. Not to scare you folks, but if I were one of you, I wouldn't really sit down here. Wasn't planning on it. The looks on your faces. Come on now, I'm just joking. At this point, my creep meter was quietly gaining at around 6 out of 10. Alrighty folks, snow's starting to pick up. Gonna hit the road, now gotta find that damn cat. By the way, what was the name on the booking? I must be getting old. This guy doesn't own the house. Thank you. Jump scared. Where are my clothes? We can both give it a shot. Yeah, 100% the guy that showed us around doesn't own the house. He's not Rick. Thank you. Got him. take a bone, throw in ginger paste, cooking oil, black pepper, salt, Italian seasoning, paprika, and yogurt. Salt. Black pepper. Paprika. Dude, where's the olive oil? Is it in like a cabinet? Oh, look up. Do you mind throwing the fish in? Two carps. Gotcha, dude. You're just in the fucking way. Where are the carbs? Oh. Where's the marinade? Where's the marinade? Oh, the veggies. What? Okay. No. Where's the marinade? Where's the marinade? it in like a cabinet or something? The marinade. Dude, what the fuck? Transparency, I just looked up where the marinade is. Okay, now I'm even more confused. Oh, I dropped it. Veggies. Now, could you add the veggies? I read it needs to go on 30 minutes of water. Board games? In here? Oh, yeah. Let's do this one. We're gonna get spooky, we might as well play this. Holly once told me how she contacted her dead. Stand your spiritual shit. Hey, remember how the dude was acting weird about the basement? What if we tried this down? Bro, you are. We're gonna get cursed. Bad feeling about this. Watch out for spiders down here. Dude, on a real note, I hate spiders so much. They creep the fuck out of me. I hate them. Nope, we'll make this even spookier. Let's turn off all these lights. I did. The light. I'm family spacebar. I'm spamming spacebar. Can I not get up? I did not know where it was there. Dude, I fucking know. I just can't get up. I'm spamming spacebar. I always have these stupid issues with these fucking games. Space to get up. Space. Questions and the spirits, if there are any, will move. Isn't it called a thing? Never mind. One more thing. Never take your fingers off. Alright then, you go first. The afterlife. I have no idea what this man's spelling out. Come on, buddy, give us a sign. Let us know you're here. I might usually end the ghost or spirits, but I'd be lying if I did, if I felt that I didn't feel uneasy that night. Some freaky shit going on down there. That was weird. What the hell, Harv? I figured you... I don't understand why you were... Had to catch that show on the TV while we ate. Where's the remote?
This delicacy is very popular in Romania, where mayonnaise flows down the rivers like a mayonnaise water park. So first, we are going to prepare the asparagus. Season these with a lot of salt. Salt is good for the bones. After letting these simmer in the salt bath, we can start making the chocolate. Take a couple cocoa beans. Yes, the cocoa beans need to be blended into the sauce with a little bit of vinegar. Gotta keep that fancy flavor in there. The next thing we prepare is the mayonnaise. We stir fry this in a pan with Irish tofu. I'm not gonna lie, this is gonna taste like shit. But here you are anyway, listening to my cooking instructions. This is the brine of the mayonnaise.
Oh my god, bro, left his plate. That door better be shut. Guy literally is a serial killer. And this, of course, we hide in the basement. One, two, three, one, Mississippi, two. dreams. Such a great idea to play hide and seek in a haunted house. Fucking in there. I'm running. I'm looking away. Wait, well, I'm upstairs. This isn't Mike. Okay, this is Mike. Oh, thank God, dude. Are you going to check it out? Yo, you, this guy's a... Bro, this... steps down this one. Wait, where? Across the way. Wait, where is the access? Oh, here. Is this the attic? What the fuck is that? Idea, bro. At least we're outside, so like we have room to run if someone comes after us. Eventually, one of these rounds is going to think it's my face, not Mike. Or it's like a possessed. mic or something. Something like that. He's probably in the attic space. Supposed to scare him. God, I hear it. Before that, it must have been an old thing you remember. You asking me to leave this? Ain't no cops in Woodbury, so you think they're gonna arrest the homeowner for fixing the faucet? I was just coming down here. You know what? You folks don't help me fix the faucet, I'll leave you to it. This guy's definitely gonna kill us. Also, I feel like he could've fixed it. Like, I feel like we're being a little mean. It's gonna be like 3 a.m. when we wake up, I assume. Something like that. 2:50, 4:04. After locking the door, we debated what to do. We agreed that there was something off about Rick from the start. It seemed like he enjoyed making excuses to come over unannounced. In the end, we decided Rick was weird, but probably harmless. We attributed his behavior to an extreme lack of social awareness. Look, we already drove all the way down here, let us enjoy the joys, as Mike said, but by the time I was feeling really tired, I decided to get some rest. 11. Oh, fuck, we were working up at that point. Oh, shit. Harvey, you still awake? Do you mind if I come in? I'd like to talk to myself.
Sure.
So, bro. The storm is starting to get really bad. I can hardly see the truck in the driveway. She'll be just fine, so don't worry. I'm here to keep you safe. So, I brought you all of this. Can you believe that guy? Just keeps wandering around. I thought you might be scared in here by yourself. Is he going to bed? Why don't you come? Harp, you know. I miss this. Just talking, it's been too long. You know, I don't have to see the one. Am I gonna something, bro? You act like you don't remember a trip to Oregon. Oh yeah, good job. I remember it being pretty awkward. Didn't start out awkward, though. You just let me worry about it.
Guys, I think I'm about 70 miles away from Woodbury and my stinking tire just blew out. It's snowing and I'm on the side of the road on Highway 11 near Killington. There's a sign by the side of the road. It's hard to see. I think it says Kent Pond. The snow is like half of a deep and I can't get the lug nuts off the tire. I hate to ask, but can you two come get me?
What does that mean, huh? No, Sydney, you stay here and get some sleep. Yeah, I'm sure we do. Of course. Jesus, dude. It's gonna be like 3:09 a.m. I told myself it would get better if I just got some rest. Nora always knew how to cheer me up and needed it more by the minute. With her arriving soon, I decided to rest in the meantime. 12:39. Dude. That Simone was in bed, I thought slide late at night was horrific. Some dude. Hello? Look, friend, I know it ain't ideal thing, but I'm in a bad spot here. I was counting on a ride from some friends, but they're running out. The weather outside. Shit. Thank you. Speaking of, I don't see your fellow's truck in here. Fine. See yourself. Didn't feel safe opening the door. Where's he going? But let me tell you something. You'll get what's coming to you. Yeah. A pitch, my friend. Which way is he going? The man at the door seemed irrelevant compared to how tired I was. We're gonna do a practical thing here. We are going to grab the flashlight from the rope. Do not throw it. Shut the door and go to bed. He's a gun. He's a hammer. He just killed that guy. He definitely just killed that guy. Is he gonna fix the faucet in the middle of the night? Let the guy in. Actually, no, I think we had to let him in anyways. Maybe we didn't, I don't remember. I knew it wasn't Rick in the beginning. That made a lot of sense. Anyways, that's the final Fears to Fathom. It's pretty good. Yeah, pretty good. Definitely near the top as far as the games are considered. Probably second or third, I'd say. Iron Beck Lookout was my favorite overall, though. Anyways, that's going to be it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. And I'll probably be playing some other games in the next few weeks. It will be pretty sporadic, though, as far as when they're coming out and everything. I'll try to find some games. I'll let you guys know what we're going to be playing. And yeah, I will see you guys in the next one. Peace. Okay, guys, so I kind of wanted to get the alternate ending, and part of it was this guy's trying to break into the bulkhead, I believe. So we're going to go back to bed and try to survive fake Rick. And I think I have an idea of how to do it. It's going to relate to the attic. Up and just hit that window. So we have to get up and go let Rick in, I think. And because of that, we're gonna go here. We have to wait for this to reset. Rick, in quotations, despite how strange Rick had been, seeing him then was a relief. Yeah, I came as quickly as I could. I wouldn't worry about him anymore. By the way, where's your friend? Mike, he went up to go pick him up. Storms like this bring out all kinds of people. I go hide now. Run! What the fuck? The way that I would escape him would be just hiding immediately. Like, open the door, wait to get the text, already be Because I think the idea would be go to the attic. Okay, I'm gonna let Eric in. Open the door. Blah blah blah. Okay, I just let him in without even thinking. I might have seen something. Could have been anyone or no one at all. I think it triggered the event, so let's go downstairs again. That cat looked really real. Wait, that's a real cat. Okay. The other idea would be the basement. Rick was in the house. Hide in the basement. Come back over. What do you mean? I live in Burlington. I haven't been in the rental in weeks. It has not been Rick. So I think I do have to trigger the event still. So so I assume it's still by the fire. Spurs didn't know. To immediately sprint out of the thing. Okay, so that just got unlocked. to trigger something? Maybe I'm safe. Cat, shut the
fuck up. Come on, Horse, it's freezing out here. Let us in.
About the ending. I told them everything that happened after Mike had left. Rick had called the cops, the storm had quieted down by the time they arrived, and of course the man was nowhere to be seen. On our drive back, the whole night played over and over and over in my head. We think that the man we saw secretly lived in the cabin when it wasn't being used and planned on robbing us during our stay. The cop seemed to think he was more intent. Yeah. Rick asked me what the man looked like after. We think he knew more than he was letting on, but in the end he gave us a full refund. There's a cutscene, guys. There's a cutscene. So that's the ending.